Welcome back, everyone. I just did another battery comparison between the Pixel 4 we newly released and the iPhone SE 2 that was also newly released, and I found some very interesting things, but ultimately it's pretty much what you guys have probably already expected it to be. So in this test, pretty much what I do, some background, I take my Pixel 4a, I put my iPhone SE 2, and I raise the brightness all the way to 100%. I charge them all the way up to 100%, and I just let them die. I use both equally. I put a timer next to them so you guys can see kind of how long they last. And I just want to get an idea of how much better of a battery one phone has over the other. And so far, out of every iteration, this is the best way I've seen it done on my channel. But if there's a way I can improve it, let me know so that I can go and fix it. If you want to see something else, if there's another way, let me know. So pretty much whatever I do on one phone, I do on the other. If I'm watching a video, if I'm playing a game, if I'm doing anything on TikTok or whatever, I go and use both of them equally, and I let them die equally on both sides. So I let them charge up, I unplug them, and about an hour and 22 minutes in, after messing around with them for a while, I saw that my iPhone SE 2 was at 77% and my Pixel 4a was at 84%. And this was actually pretty good. You know, this was the battery life I was expecting it to happen. The iPhone SE 2 has like a 1700 mAh battery. The Pixel 4a has over a 3100 mAh battery, just a little bit over that. And so I was already kind of expecting it. But it's weird though, because the Pixel 4a does actually have a high resolution panel and a bigger panel than the SE 2. I wasn't expecting it to be this big of a difference, but I was in for a super shock later on. So about an hour after that, about 2 hours and 25 minutes in, I saw that my iPhone SE 2 was at 54%, and my Pixel 4a was at 69%. So that was another big thing. I wasn't expecting to see this big of a difference already. I mean, it was still a 15% difference or so, but that's kind of a big deal, especially this early on. I mean, we were 2.5 hours in. I played some games, like I said. I kind of messed with them a little bit here and there. But I was saying that the iPhone SE 2 was just dying way faster than I was expecting it to. And this is the craziest part. So about an hour and a half after that, so about 3 hours 57 minutes in, almost 4 hours in, again, I mess around with them a lot, I play with them, I saw that my iPhone SE 2 was at 21%, my Pixel 4a was on 50%, and again, that's a huge difference. I mean, at this point, you're almost getting twice the amount of battery life from a Pixel 4a than on an iPhone SE 2 just at this point. So we're at over a 29% advantage on the Pixel 4a, and like I said, both these phones are brand new. I purchased them both brand new, or Pixel 4a was given to me, but that's a pretty big difference between them, and that was really, really surprising to me. And then eventually what I did, about half an hour after that, about 4 hours and 20-something minutes in, I saw that my iPhone SE 2 was at 12%, my Pixel 4a was on 44%, and so I ultimately saw that, yeah, the iPhone SE 2 was probably going to die first, and I just didn't want to mess with it and let them die all the way. And ultimately, I saw that my Pixel 4a was truly the winner here. So what does this mean? This means that if you get the Pixel 4a, you're probably going to have better battery life on it than on an iPhone SE 2. And like I said, I used them equally. I did all things the same. And the Pixel 4a definitely had the better battery life for sure. I did see, though, that my Galaxy S10e did have the better battery life, though, between the Pixel 4a and even the SE 2. That one had way better battery life. So if you were trying to get the best battery life for the cheapest phone, the S10e may still be the better way to go. But for my battery test, I saw that the Pixel 4a was the better battery life between these two. So that's really pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. More important than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.